down. Look how she rubs her hands together.
It is an accustomed action to be washing her hands. I have known her to continue this a quarter of an hour. Yet, here's the spot.
Hark, she speaks. Now I'll write down what she says to satisfy my presence more strongly.
Out, damn spot. Out, I say. Who'd have thought the king to have so much blood in him?
You mark that.
What? Will these hands never be clean?
We have heard what we should not.
She has found what she should not. I am sure of that.
Heaven knows what we have not seen. Here's the smell of the blood still. Not all the perfumes of radia, sweetness, little hands.
What a sight. This disease is beyond my practice.
Put on your nightgown. Look not so pale. I tell you again, Banquo is buried. He cannot come out of his grave.
Terrible.
To bed. There's knocking at the gate. Come. Give me your hand. What's done cannot be undone. To bed.
Won't you now to bed?
Directly.
Lord, if I am in a position. Good God, forgive us all. I think what dare not speak.
Good night, good doctor. Tonight, the best path will keep me clear.
No more reports of the burn of white shall go to judgment. Macbeth shall never fight for speed. The heart I bear shall never shake with fear. What is it now, green face learned? What is wrong with that juice look?
There are 10,000
beasts, villains, soldiers, sir.
Thou lily liver for the white soldiers.
The English soldiers, get thy face away.
What is that noise?
It's a cry of water, my lord.
Scream again.
Queen, my lord, is dead.
Tomorrow, creeps in this petty pace from day to day, to the last syllable of recorded time. And all yesterday's white fools awaited us to death. Out, big candle, lies for a walking shadow. A poor player that struts and frets is hour upon his back, and then is heard no more. It is a tale told by an idiot, signifying nothing. What is thy message? Quickly!
I should report what I saw, but I know that I have to say it.
Well, say it!
As I stood my watch upon the hill, I looked for Brentwood, and I thought the wood began to move.
Liar and slave!
Let me adjure you, man, if it be not so. Within the 3 miles, you may see a purpose, a moving grown.
Fear not, till Brentwood you move to Dunsany. And now we would come toward Dunsany. Ring the alarm bells, at least we'll die with harnesses on our back. Bowman else I avoided thee. It gives thee back, and so it's too much charge in blood of thine already.
I have no order. I always give my sword, thy bloody villain.
I will not fight with thee.
Then yield, coward, and loose Fremont. We'll have you penned upon a pole and under a pyramid to the fire.
I will not yield. Land McDuff and damn him at first cries, hold it up.
Hail, King of Scotland, so thou art. Behold, where stands the earth for his cursed head. The time is brief. Hail, King of Scotland.
Hail, King of Scotland!
Mary Clissold, Malcom, Steve Harris, Donalbain, Karen Magyar, Macbeth, Brien Kaiser, and Brien Blumen, Banquo, Jason Coughlin, Fleance, David Detroy, Macduff, David Detroy, Ross, Anna Overy, Lennox, Craig Hallstrom, Lady Macbeth, Ansley Carter, First Witch, Anne-Marie Brisby. Second Witch, Otto Gentry. Third Witch, Shannon Lee, and the piano player. Porter, Aaron Marie. Messenger, Aaron Barton. Servants, Susie Beckett, Chrissy Slaydeck, Brock Kidd, and Stacey Braswell. First Murderer, Stephen Miller. Second Murderer, Karen Magyar. Third Murderer, Chris Willis. First Apparition, Aaron Martin. Second Apparition, Anna Overy. Doctor, Craig Hallstrom. Gentlewoman, Aaron Marie. Guest at the Banquet, Chris DeWitted, Laura Adams, Vanessa Lilly, soldiers John Jewell, Josh Chapman, Spence Anderson, announcers Brent Sharp and Leslie Beale, stage manager Stephen Miller, sound effects Aaron Martin and Chrissy Playdeck. The prompter was Rob Kidd. Thank you.